Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video EDATE Excel function, watch the video till the end. And also, if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Let's begin with today's topic. That's the EDATE Excel function. It's a date and a time function Excel. Let's understand this in a much more detailed format. Now, the EDATE function is basically, you know, if you see, it is a built-in function. It is a built-in function in MS Excel, and the EDATE function falls under the category of date and time. So those are the two functions, the date and the time function in Excel. The EDATE in Excel is used to get the date on the same day of the month. Like X month in the past or future. So the EDATE function returns the serial number of the date, that is indicated number of the months before or after given the start date. So the EDATE function in Excel is used to calculate the expiration dates and maturity dates and other due dates. So to get a date in the future and use a positive value for the month and a negative value for the dates in the past. So let's start with EDATE. Just write EDATE. You will get start date in months. So EDATE in Excel has two arguments out of which both are required. The start date is the date that represents the start date in a valid Excel serial number format. And then there is months. So the number of the months before and after the start date. Now how to use this EDATE function in Excel? The EDATE function in Excel is basically a worksheet function. And as a worksheet function, EDATE in Excel can be entered as a part of the formula in a cell of worksheet. So you can refer to a couple of examples that's going to be taught here also. Let's look at the EDATE function example, and each example will cover a different use in case of implementing using the EDATE function. Example number one, EDATE in Excel example one, get the same data for the 3 months later here. The date for the year and the date for the next year. So how are you going to do is equal to EDATE. What is going to be the start date? Is this B2? The end date is 3. That's number of months. Close the bracket and you have the answer. Right. So in this above example, it returns a date which is 3 months later than the date mentioned in cell B2. And cell B2 has a date 23rd September 2018. So the date after the 3 months is 23rd December 2018, and the same is displayed as a result in cell C2, wherein the EDATE function is applied. Right, just do Control D and you will have the answer for the second one also. Well, let's take example number two. You add months to the date. How are you going to do that? In the this particular example, cell B5 to B7 contains the source data, and cell C6 to C7 contains the number of the months to be added from the date of the B column. So what's going to be the result here? CD5 to D7 contains the result date, and the EDATE function used in EDATE B5, what we simply have to do is equal to EDATE, and then we have to pick up the start date, that is B5, comma, the months, that's C5, do Control D. So row 5, the date is the 1st Jan 2018, and 12 months are added to the date, resulting in the date 1st Jan 2019. Row 6, the date is 10 Jan, from which year, that is 12 months are deducted, resulting into the date as 10 Jan 2017. And row 7 here, the source data is 23rd September 2018, to which 24 months, that is 2 years, and are added, and as a result, the date is 23rd September 2020. So the EDATE in Excel, example number 3 over here, is retirement date and number of years date that are left. So in the above example, the birth date is given from using the birth date C column B, and the retirement age criteria. The retirement date is calculated in the column number C, and the years left is in column number D, wherein the number of the years of the service left is calculated using the year FARC Excel function. So first, we'll start as EDATE. Using EDATE, you will use B10, comma, number of months is 12 into 58. And for the rest, and as shown here, the about EDATE function Excel box, that is EDATE B10, comma, 12 into 58. B10 contains the birth date, which is the 12th May 1965. So in the about screen, as you can see, the retirement date is calculated, but how it is done. So for the retirement date, for the number of years left, how you will do that? You will just write year F, that's called FRAC function. In that, you use today's function. In just today function, just close it with brackets, don't add anything. And comma C10, bracket close, and the number of years left is here. Now the same EDATE function is applied to the remaining two rows, that is B11 and C11. Right. So cell B11 contains the birth as 5th September 1962 and the retirement date calculated is 5th September 2020, which is 58 years from the birth date, and the year left in the cell D11 is calculated to be closely around 1.2, which is 1 year and 2 months from the today's date. Now the last example. In this particular example, cell B14 contains the start date or the manufacturing date of the product. Cell C14 contains the duration for which the product can be consumed. Cell D14 is the result cell, which indicates the expiry of the date of the product. And here, 3rd April 2018 is the manufacturing date and the duration of the 30 days, which means 1 month. And so the EDATE formula applied is over here. EDATE start date. Over here, we'll need to use something like this. B14, comma, number of months is 1. That gives us 30th May 18. Right. So the EDATE formula applied is EDATE B14 1, and the result is 3rd May 2018, which is 1 month. So after the start of the cell, cell D14 contains the result here. Now, there are some of the things to remember about this particular thing is that, you know, first, the second parameter of the EDATE in Excel returns the positive number. Second, if the start date is an invalid date, then the EDATE in Excel returns to the value error. Third, if the month is not an integer, the value is truncated to be an integer. And last, here the Microsoft Excel it stores the data it stores the dates as sequential serial number, so they can be used in calculations. So by default, January 1st, 1900 is serial number 1, and January 1, 2001 serial number is 36892. This is going to be the scenario. So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching the video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone for joining. Cheers.